there's been a lot of talk about using a metronome in this Facebook group called the Violin Guild. It has like 41,000 members, and there have been like over 140 comments on this one post. Should you be practicing with a metronome, or should you teach using a metronome? I have some mixed feelings on the topic, so stick around. I'll share my thoughts with you in just a moment. Hi, violinists of YouTube. I'm Eric. I'm a violinist. If you're new to the channel, thanks so much for stopping by. If you haven't done so already, please make sure to hit the subscribe button, hit the bell notification, that way you get notified for when new videos come out. It also helps me out to provide more videos for you. I'm torn between this conversation of should you use a metronome, should you not use a metronome, because I am a firm believer of the metronome. Here's why you need to practice with the metronome, people. You don't practice with the metronome just to get it right. You practice with the metronome so that way you can never get it wrong. And I think that's the most valuable lesson that you can get out of practicing with the metronome. You know, people come from different schools, and whether you're a fiddler, I'm a classical musician, or a jazz violin, I think there's something to be said about having like a good internal pulse. And the only way to really learn about having that internal pulse is by using a metronome. I use this with every single student and every single lesson, and some of them are like, no, I hate the metronome. But no, you need to practice with the metronome because it's for your own good. And then once you become pro, and once you become more in sync with like your rhythm inside your body, and you can really, really feel that rhythm, then you are at a point where you can be a little bit more flexible, right? That's why in like the old international editions, you don't have just like one strict tempo unless like the composer said them themselves. But sometimes the editor would be like between like 80 beats per minute, or the coordinate will be like between 80 and 95. Because the tempo does fluctuate and does become more fluid once you become more comfortable with collaborating with another artist or a quartet. I agree that not every single piece of music out there needs to be like completely metronome driven. You know, if you're playing solo, more like sonatas or chamber quartets, you wanna have that sense of pulse, but then you're given a little bit of liberty as to how you can utilize that tempo, how you can utilize metronome practice to help you play better. The contrary, if you are like an orchestral musician, or you're preparing excerpts, like orchestra excerpts, or if you're a young beginner student trying to learn the ways of the metronome gods, you want to be able to, you know, master practicing with the metronome, which is why I'm really proud to partner with Soundbrenner. Soundbrenner is a really cool app, and they also have a lot of products that help you practice with the metronome. To me, it's the best app out there. The app is absolutely free. I think there's a subscription related to that. Soundbrenner is a company that is like revolutionizing the metronome market. And I think as we continue moving forward into the 21st century, I think metronomes are gonna be digital. I think we're not gonna be using the old metronome, although that's like really like vintage. I really like that. But you know, it's more convenient to have a metronome in your pocket, in your phone. Also, they have a lot of cool products like a metronome watch where you can tap on the metronome and it's going to sync with the app in the phone. And I'm proud to give 20% off anybody who's interested in this product. I'm gonna leave a affiliate link down below so that way you can get a hold of this Soundbrenner product. Again, you wanna practice with the metronome so that way you can never get things wrong. And then, you know, once you become pro, and if you play in orchestras, or if you become a professional violinist playing sonatas, chamber music, or if you're in an orchestra, nobody wants to play with anybody who's out of tune, and nobody wants to play with anybody who has not a good sense of tempo and rhythm. And those are the three pillars for me as a violinist and as a collaborator that I kind of search in, and I kind of choose my co-workers wisely in that sense. I want to make sure I'm playing with reliable people who have good rhythm, good intonation, and good tempo. So should you practice with the metronome? Absolutely. Do you also have the liberty to not practice with the metronome? Yes, because you want to be able to internalize the metronome inside you. You can't rely on the training wheels all the time. I do agree with that. But there's something to be said to have the metronome constantly in your practice regimen and be a presence in your practicing. I hope you found value in this video, and everybody, practice with the metronome. Please practice with the metronome. If you like the video, please make sure to hit the like button. Make sure you hit the subscribe button if you haven't done so already. I do a lot of violin content on the channel, and would love to have you around, and stick around for some more videos right here and right here. Thanks so much.